Vicky Lynn here, and welcome back to my channel. So today, I finally decided on which phone I wanted, and as you can tell from the title already, I have gone with the iPhone 11 in this beautiful purple color. And yes, I did paint my nails to match the phone. Don't judge me. Whatever iPhone you choose, you can kind of see the color in the lettering. You can see the color in the Apple as well. So I decided to go with the 64 gigabyte. After watching the Apple event and really contemplating on which phone I wanted, at first my first thought was to get the Pro Max in the gold color. 64 gigabytes, I don't need no more than 64 gigabytes on any phone. But then I started weighing down all the pros and the cons and all of the options that each phone has after watching tons and tons of unboxing videos. I ultimately went with the iPhone 11 mainly because the value is just overall better. You're just missing out a little bit on the display compared to the Pro and the Pro Max. When I think of the word Pro, I was honestly thinking of another type of phone that does a little bit more than what the Pro and the Pro Max does. I don't know about you, but the word Pro is pretty serious in the tech world. I'm secretly a tech geek, so you know, it's kind of showing right now, but that's okay. I didn't see myself paying $300 to $400 more dollars for the Pro phone when it doesn't even have what a lot of these Android phones have that they've had for a while. It's like Apple like needs to play catch up. I don't know what's going on, but next year I am anticipating this phone for next year. Everyone is anticipating this phone for next year. Allegedly, it's supposed to be like this huge refresh, and it's supposed to be just this grand new phone, and everyone's gonna want it. It's gonna sell like hotcakes. Well, we'll see. I just thought that this was the smarter choice for me, was to get the 11. And then honestly, this purple color, I couldn't turn that purple color down. Whoa, look at that color. Best part ever. Well, they do have like, I think, two other new colors. They have that green teal looking color, and then they have the yellow color. They have the product red that's been out, and then they have the white. They have it in white and black, I believe. I couldn't decide at first between the purple color or that teal looking color, but the longer I started looking at that teal color, I'm like, oh my gosh, it's starting to look like the color of Nickelodeon slime. That's what it was starting to look like to me. So I was like, nope, gotta go with the purple. So with the iPhone 11, you have the 6.1 LCD display. It claims to have an all-day battery. I'm not sure about that. It definitely has a better battery for sure than from my 6S Plus. Then you have your dual cameras on the back. It shoots in 4K from the front-facing camera, 60 frames. You have an A13 Bionic chip, and then it's supposed to be water resistant. I'm not sure how long you can keep it in water, but I won't be dropping my phone in the water. I never have, I never will. I am very responsible with my phones, okay? So I'm upgrading from a 6S Plus, and I have it in the rose gold pinkish kind of color. I've had this phone for almost 4 years, and I just want to point out there's not a scratch or a dent in sight, and my screen is immaculate. No chips, no breakage, never dropped it. I even had a little video that I did years ago on my channel where I did a little small unboxing, and I was talking about like cases that you can get from the Dollar Tree. I'll link it up at the top, and I also will link up at the top my case collection video for my 6S Plus. I have over 50 cases for that phone. So I was having trouble with the battery life for my 6S Plus. When I would use certain apps, the battery would just go down like instantly. So I don't know what was up with that. It didn't used to do that. And then also the front facing camera is trash. I'm just gonna say it. It's trash. The back camera, it's okay. When I take like outside pictures, the pictures don't look that bad. But when I take inside pictures, the pictures just don't look that good to me. So yeah, those were the two main reasons why I decided to upgrade, was for the camera and the battery life. The iPhone 11, in my opinion, is almost just as good as the Pro and the Pro Max. I think the iPhone 11 is the smarter choice, in my opinion. This feels so much better in the hand versus my 6S Plus. I have small hands anyway. I'm like struggling with my thumb sometimes to like reach different apps, but this phone, it's a lot easier for me to like go to different apps and I'm not straining my thumb. The 11 might be a little bit heavier. I'm not sure. The display is bigger versus my 6S Plus. I also have to get used to not using a home button. That's gonna be the hardest challenge for me. I'm gonna tell you that right now. I'm already looking for it. And it's not there. All right, so now that we have 100 fingerprints on the phone, let's get a closer look. So of course inside we have all of our documentation. Really, I don't read this stuff. I don't think anyone does, but for real, the only thing that better be in there is those Apple stickers. So I don't even use the stickers, but it's just one of those things where like, you know, they just better be in there. So inside, we have our AirPods. I have enough pairs of these. I don't even know if I'm gonna use these. Honestly, I'm thinking about investing into AirPods, but I think the newest AirPods are supposed to come out in the beginning of next year, if I'm not mistaken. So I'm just gonna wait around until the newest version of the AirPods come out. And then, of course, we have our charger. I'm not even gonna take that out. You can see it, but we have our charger. And then we have the 5-watt charger that we always get. Now the pros, you can get the faster charger, but honestly, that doesn't really bother me. I don't really care. You can buy it separately if you want the fast charging brick, but this is good enough for me. Yeah, that is everything inside of the box. Move that over, so let's get back to the iPhone. So let's turn this on and see how it looks. Oh, there we go. There's that glorious Apple. Hey! So this is gonna take me a long time to set up. So I'm gonna set this up and I will be right back with you shortly. Okay, so I finally have my phone set up. Now I did set up Face ID and everything, and I set up the display and everything looks pretty good. So let's see. I don't know if it's gonna recognize my face from where I am. Oh yeah, it did. I have to get used to this not having a home button. Okay, so here's like the display. It looks gorgeous. I had that True Tone display on and I did play around with the brightness a little bit. So yeah, some of my apps are still updating. So there's the display of the two phones. The 11 looks like it has more of like a yellow undertone to it. The display, it definitely does look a little bit larger from the 6S. I'm definitely gonna miss the home button though and the fingerprint sensor. Well, 6S, it was nice knowing you. 11, we got some work to do. I'm still looking for the home button. So to protect my phone, I did get these. Well, I got this from Best Buy. I really do enjoy a pop socket. I got this one to kind of match the purple color on the phone. And then I got this clear case from Amazon. I've seen cases on Amazon for as cheap as $5, but I paid $15 or $16 for this. I wanted a clear case, but I wanted it to have something on it. I didn't want it to just be straight plain. Let's put this inside of our case. Very nice fit. And the phone edges are covered up pretty nicely, so it's definitely gonna protect it. This looks so good together. I really like this together. I also have to get used to not having a headphone jack anymore, but here are the speakers on the bottom here. Oh, I'm gonna miss my headphone jack. So here is my pop socket all attached, and I think the colors go pretty well together. That is so pretty, so girly. I'm gonna play around with the camera a little bit. Here's my blotting sheet. Wow, oils are really coming through.
Here's that camera, one time, 0.5 times. It shifts very easily. It's not noticeable. Then portrait mode.
So at the bottom, you can swipe over to like take a picture while you're in video mode. Okay, so while you're in photo mode, you can swipe over to the right and it'll start taking a video. Studio light's a little high, but I really like the natural lighting option on portrait mode. It looks really good. Wow, my selfie's about to be fire. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. This is Vicky Lynn here. I am signing out. But on your way out, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, like my videos, and share my videos as well. Thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know down below in the comment section if you have an iPhone 11, an 11 Pro Max, or an 11 Pro, or if you just want to keep the phone that you have now. Let me know what phone that you have now. You know, let me know if you're gonna wait till next year to get the new iPhone. Let me know if you are strictly Android. If you want me to do a what's on my iPhone video, let me know down below. I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.